Hello, everyone. Welcome to another edition of the Library Marketing Show. I'm Angela Hirsch from superlibrarymarketing.com, the website that helps you with your library marketing. You can head there and click on the Library Marketing Show tab to ask me to answer a question for you in a future episode or nominate your library or another library for kudos. We'll get to kudos in a moment. The other thing you can do at superlibrarymarketing.com is check out the 2023 Guide to Social Media for Libraries. We're in the middle of it. I've been releasing one blog post a week covering all the major platforms that most libraries are using to communicate with their cardholders and their community. So head there to check that out. And it's relevant to today because it's the end of the month and we're going to do our social media roundup, the top headlines for libraries. I have two stories to share with you today. The first is about TikTok. TikTok has released new audience insights. Now, this feature is in testing, so it may not be available in your area. The other thing to remember is you have to have a pro TikTok account in order to get TikTok analytics in any form. So I'm going to, if you're watching on YouTube, down in the show description box, at the very bottom are links for the episode. You will find a couple of links there. First, one that explains what the difference is between audience insights and the regular TikTok analytics, and also how to change your account to a pro account so you can start to really better understand your audience. But audience insights is going to be super cool, and you don't have to buy an ad on TikTok to see them. However, while we're thinking, I don't know what the prices are, but wouldn't it be interesting if a library started advertising on TikTok? I'm just going to throw it out there. Anyway, in TikTok, the audience insights are very, very cool. And they have four basic things that they're going to be able to tell you about your audience. First, what their interests are, what their behaviors are, and what their demographics are. That is going to help you to figure out if TikTok is really a place where you should be spending time doing library marketing. Secondly, it's going to help you to figure out which audience is responding to which type of content you're putting on TikTok. And it's going to supposedly help you with workflow so that your TikToks that you do post are more effective. So that's really exciting. I love that they are starting to really get into analyzing the audience and giving us more tools to help libraries make decisions about what to post and if to post at all on TikTok. So again, check the show description if you're watching on YouTube. If you're watching on LinkedIn, I'll put all those links in the comments so you can see that as well. The second story is a fascinating new study that came from the Pew Research Center, and it focused on how teenagers use social media apps and whether or not they think social media is a way for them to connect. The news is teenagers view social media as a very legitimate way for them to connect with friends and family, to be supported in difficult times. There is a section of this study that also asked them about what we know to be the negative effects of social media, especially peer pressure, being afraid to post things because of retaliation. This study from Pew shows that older teenagers are often more afraid to post things because of retaliation. Maybe that's experience for them. Maybe it's just because they've been using social media for longer. But I was really fascinated by the beginning of this article, which talks about the connective parts of social media. And I thought it would be interesting, especially for those of you who are working with teenagers and or trying to create content for teenagers, to see they view social media as a connection for them. And so I think libraries can be a supportive place, especially for kids from marginalized communities, and we can use social media in that way. So I bet there are lots and lots of things that you're going to, that are going to pop out at you when you read this study. The link will be down in the show description for YouTube or in the comments for LinkedIn. And I'm super curious what you all think about these two stories today. Are you on TikTok and will you use the analytics? And what do you think about social media and teenagers and how that impacts the work that we do in library marketing? Let's start a conversation. Let me know in the comments, either platform. Remember, you can go to superlibrarymarketing.com to nominate a library for kudos. Kudos today is going to go to the Meridian Library district officials in Idaho. So they have been faced with some First Amendment challenges. And there is an article that I'm going to link to down in the show description or in the comments. But basically, their board is saying, book bans, we're not doing it. We're not doing it. And at a recent board meeting, they had some folks who came for the public comment section, but who got very disruptive. They used defamatory language. They were threatening. They were disruptive. And the board member said, no more public comments. I wanted to point this out because oftentimes library boards feel like they need to let people who are challenging books have their say. There is a both sides thing that's happening. And I sometimes don't think both sides is a good option for libraries. I think we should take a stand to protect the freedom to read for all members of our community. And so I just wanted to say to the Meridian Library District, I applaud you for taking the stance with your community. All right. That's it for today's episode. If you haven't yet subscribed to my channel on YouTube, please do so. There's a big subscribe button down there. You can follow me on LinkedIn. As always, I appreciate the time that you spend with me every week, and I'll see you next time.